The Bombay High Court has granted bail to the Pune minor who was involved in a car accident case in May. Let's speak to the lawyer representing the minor's aunt who had approached the Bombay High Court. So if you can just tell us, what really did the court say while passing the order today?
See, today we had moved the writ of habeas corpus before the Honorable Bombay High Court. The genesis of the entire writ petition was Section 12 of Juvenile Justice Act. Section 12 of Juvenile Justice Act is extremely clear that be it a bailable offence or a non-bailable offence, the code of CRPC, that is the Criminal Procedure Code, is not applicable when it comes to a child in conflict in law. So when this particular child in conflict in law was released on bail on 19th May 2024, because of the public outcry, 22nd May 2024, the Juvenile Justice Board took the detention. They again sent him to an observation home, which was extended on 5th June and also on 12th June of 2024.
Which the Bombay High Court has very clearly said that those remands were illegal.
Especially illegal on the light of Section 12. Also, there are the guidelines of the Honorable Supreme Court that this particular offence cannot be treated as an heinous offence. So, based on this genesis, the writ of habeas corpus has been allowed today and the child in conflict in law has to be released immediately from the illegal detention.
Also, the High Court, you know, during the entire hearing was very clear as to how, you know, as you had also pointed out that the bail that had been granted was still alive. It had not been challenged by the Pune police. It had not been, set aside by any court. Apart from that, instead of challenging the entire bail application, they had also moved the very sheer fact that, you know, they had gone in asking that he be sent to an observation home without saying that the parents were unfit or the grandfather or any other family member was not available.
See, the crux of the argument was this again. The prosecution wanted the child in conflict in law to go at observation house. But however, the procedure under 101 or 104 of the Juvenile Justice Act was not followed. That was our submission before the court on law point. See, if you want to cancel a bail of any particular person, the liberty can be infringed only by following the due process of law. And the due process of law is by moving an application under Section 439, Subclause 2 of CRPC. In this case, particularly, it was not done, but whatever the prosecution did, according to them, was right. I'm not going into the merits then what is the correct legal position. Our case was in whichever case, whatever due process of law you follow. According to Section 12 of JJ Act, Juvenile Justice Act, you cannot detain a particular child in conflict in law like this, the manner in which in this particular matter it was detained.
Also, if I can just ask you, prosecution had also moved an application stating that he be treated as an adult. What's the status of that application?
So an application has been moved by the prosecution that this particular child in conflict in law has to be treated as an adult. That particular application is squarely covered by the guidelines of the Honorable Supreme Court in one of the judgments already passed on similar facts.
Yeah, but then what is the status of the application?
That application is still pending for arguments because we are still awaiting the so-called final report filed on the last occasion by the prosecution, which has not been served upon us. Once it is served upon us, we file a reply.
While the Bombay High Court has directed that the entire detention of the minor be considered illegal and he be released, an application filed by prosecution seeking that he be treated as an adult, that's still pending and that's still to be heard. Vidya in Mumbai for India Today.